In this video, we will introduce concepts needed to design and write software for an embedded system. Software engineers often want to jump straight into coding before putting time into code design and architecture. Good software design needs to understand what the purpose and required operation specifications that a project needs. It's good to start by breaking a software concept down into flow diagrams or software blocks. A flow diagram can depict how a particular piece of software or algorithm should behave. Often it contains the same functional software constructs such as conditional decisions and high-level function calls. Software block diagrams do not differ greatly from a hardware block diagram that you often see for circuit boards or microcontrollers. Instead, they depict how different blocks of code communicate and connect to one another. That being said, a software block diagram can also depict a software system in layers. An example of a typical software organization can be seen with an OS-based design. There are low-level device drivers that interact with hardware. There is software to help boot or start the system. There is an operating system to schedule processes and manage resources. There are shared libraries that many software components use. And finally, the higher-level software reflects user applications. Writing code to directly interface with the hardware is referred to as bare metal firmware. Bare metal code has a steep learning curve, and we will be focusing on this in the course. A firmware engineer requires deep knowledge of the hardware, not only for configuration of the bare metal, but also for hardware timing and limitations related to their software design. A software engineer's role will be to try and segment the hardware interface into something referred to as a HAL, or a hardware abstraction layer. By design, this interface works as a module component with a well-defined interface. It allows software above the HAL layers to become platform independent or agnostic to the specific hardware implementation, making certain layers portable across platforms. In general, for each of the blocks in our software system, you need to know what their responsibilities are and how the different blocks interface with one another. This is especially important for the pieces that need to interact with the underlying hardware. We will also need to put some time into understanding the hardware specs that affect the software design as we try to engineer the best solution. Remember, embedded systems are highly specialized with limited resources. A common software block design method is called component design. This is where we define small functional software blocks that have certain tasks. We define the interface mechanisms and the specs that each module needs to adhere to. By doing this, you can build modularized software that is reusable across different systems, architectures, and platforms. This will allow software developers to easily migrate certain software solutions without significant system changes. It is very important you understand that with this design paradigm, good interface definitions are a key for successful implementation. Example components can be seen in the layers where a wireless control embedded system is built. There is a HAL or firmware layer that controls peripheral hardware. There is an abstracted interface to this layer that is hardware independent. Those are interfaced with some high-level communication libraries. Above that is a control library that utilizes different hardware interfaces. Historically, a software engineer was dependent on the development of hardware systems. Hardware designers provided the specification that software engineers would use to interface with the hardware layer. Without hardware, no on-target testing could occur. On-target testing is just a term that refers to installing your code onto your particular embedded system instead of another. So new chipsets or printed circuit boards had to be built with the desired hardware and connections so the software engineer knew what they needed to configure. Thankfully, new hardware development techniques and system emulation provide quality resources for low-level development. Take, for example, the introduction of development kits and the SDKs that allow us to rapidly prototype software. This not only enabled engineers to begin writing low-level code or firmware, but also provided them with the physical resources to test code on. We discuss development kits in more detail later in the module. There are five main development tools that allow software engineers to get started on their development and testing of their applications. These are, first, simulators, software that imitates your intended hardware's behavior without the actual hardware. Emulators, it's a hardware platform that imitates the operation of your intended system. Compilers, this is software that allows developers to create executable code for their intended architecture. Installers, a software-hardware combination that allows compiled executable programs to be installed onto a platform. And debuggers, a hardware-software solution that allows programmers to test and validate their executable programs. These tools are important because developing hardware takes time and it's expensive. The software engineer's role oftentimes will not only include the design of the software product, but also software validation of the hardware platform. The complete hardware design and documentation usually finishes first, with software following. These five tools make the job of the embedded software engineer easier. How? Simulators and emulators will allow validation and design to occur before the arrival of hardware. Compilers, installers, and debuggers will provide a quick development of features for your embedded target and an easy way to fix software bugs. Having the ability to do this in software gives a team more flexibility and likely a cheaper product development cost. Prototyping software fast is important, but not at the cost of quality. This leads to the principles of high-quality software. These principles are beliefs that every software engineer should keep in mind as they write code to achieve maximum amount of quality. This list includes, but is not limited to, writing code that is maintainable, testable, portable, robust, efficient, and consistent. By keeping these tenets in mind with software, you can ultimately write better code, speed up development by reusing old code, and produce consistent bug-free software. A common misconception is that the advanced platform a general programmer might use, that the advanced hardware will make up for poorly written software. This is not true, especially from an embedded perspective, because even the best hardware cannot make up for buggy, slow, or inefficient embedded code. By putting time into architecting your software, writing code effectively, making it modular, you can extend the lifetime and reusability of these pieces over various projects and platforms. This obviously speeds up embedded systems prototyping timelines and the rate with which you can hit the market with your product. There are many embedded software languages used in the industry, such as C, C++, Java, and Ada, but C programming is the most widely used language for embedded software design. C programming has benefits for both low-level hardware interaction and high-level software language features. This provides portability across different embedded platforms. Software engineers choose to use this over assembly language for many reasons. C is high-level enough that you do not need to know every detail about the very specific assembly-level architectures. Assembly is often still used together with C for a small number of embedded features, but in very few regular occurrences. Regardless, all higher level languages need to be converted into the architecture-specific language before installation can occur. Typical embedded engineers actually write a form of C called embedded C. Embedded C differs from C because it puts a focus on the following features: efficient memory management, timing-centric operations, direct hardware I/O control, code size constraints, and optimized execution. In general, you can think of embedded C as optimum features in minimum space and time. Putting some thought and design time into your embedded software project is important before you begin coding. You have many tools at your disposal to help you in your development. Do not be afraid to use them. Your goal should be to design high-quality software that could help prevent bugs and even provide reusability of code. These tools and concepts will help us write the most efficient embedded C programs for our projects.